Hi friends, in this video we are going to learn a concept of resonance in AC parallel circuit. Whether it's a parallel or series circuit, the concept of resonance remains same. And what is that? At resonance, the current taken by the circuit is always in phase with a voltage applied. What is the meaning of in phase? In phase is nothing but phase angle between voltage and current is zero. This is a property of resistive circuit. What does that mean? Despite of having inductor and capacitor in the circuit, at resonance, circuit behave like a resistive circuit. Being a zero phase angle, the power factor of the circuit will be unity. So these are the properties of any type of resonance. Now we are going to learn resonance with the help of a parallel circuit, which is more often we deal. So let's study that. So I will have a voltage source with a variable frequency. Because resonance is a property or it is a function of a frequency, this AC supply is given to a circuit having one practical coil connected parallel to the pure capacitor C. Now we are going to derive an expression of resonant frequency first. As we know, XL and XC is nothing but 2 pi FL, which we call as inductive reactance, and XC as 1 upon 2 pi FC. Capacitive reactance. XL, XC both are the functions of frequency. So therefore you are having a variable frequency, and at one particular frequency the circuit behave like a resistive circuit. What does that mean? The phase angle between voltage and current is zero. So what we will do first? We will consider this as a branch number 1, this as a branch number 2. So for branch number 1, I will consider impedance Z1 as R plus J XL. Its corresponding admittance Y1 will be 1 upon Z1. So I substitute, I will get 1 upon R plus J XL. To get a proper complex number, I will multiply and divide by complex conjugate. So R minus JXL getting multiplied as well as getting divided. So if I solve, I will get Y1 as R minus JXL, R plus JXL, R minus JXL. I will use a formula A plus B, A minus B. A square minus b square. So this will give me r minus jxl upon r square plus xl square. So if I simplify, I will get y1 as r upon r square plus xl square minus j times xl upon r square plus xl square. I will consider this as equation number 1. Second branch is this pure capacitance. So its impedance Z2 equal to minus J XC. So corresponding admittance Y2 equal to 1 upon Z2 equal to 1 upon minus J XC. If I take this J up, this minus sign will go. So it's J upon XC, equation number 2. Now total admittance of the circuit will be nothing but addition of Y1 and Y2. So Y1 is R upon R square plus XL square minus J XL upon R square plus XL square plus J upon XC. So total admittance is also a complex number with a real term R upon R square plus XL square, and imaginary part is 1 upon XC minus XL upon R square plus XL square. Now at resonance, circuit behave like a resistive circuit. That means imaginary part of impedance or imaginary part of total admittance equal to 0. So at resonance, imaginary part of YT is 0. So if I consider the imaginary part of YT is 0, that means I need to equate this part to 0. So if I do that, what I will get? 1 upon XC minus XL upon R square plus XL square equal to 0. So if I simplify further, I will get XL upon R square plus XL square equal to 1 upon XC. Let's cross multiply. So if I substitute XL as 2 pi FRL, why FR? Because this particular phenomena is appearing only when F equal to FR, and X is 1 upon 2 pi FRC equal to R square plus 2 pi FRL whole square. So 2 pi FR get cancelled, I will get L by C equal to R square plus 4 pi square FR square L square. Remember, I need to get an expression of FR. So I will keep 4 pi square L square multiplied by FR square on this side, and here I will have LC minus R square. So if I take the root, I will get root of LC minus R square equal to 2 pi L FR. Let's take this 2 pi L over here in order to get FR. So FR equal to 1 upon 2 pi L under root L by C minus R square. let's rearrange the term properly, meaning I will take this L inside a root, so it will become L square. So after simplifying, I will get FR is 2 pi root of 1 by LC minus R square by L square. So this is the expression of resonant frequency I will get at which the circuit behaves like a resistive circuit. Let's find out its resistance, which we call as dynamic resistance. So for that purpose, let's go back to Yt once again. So Yt is like this. At resonance, this term is becoming 0. So at resonance, Yt is nothing but R upon R square plus XL square. This is a admittance. We want resistance or impedance, you can say. So that we call as a dynamic resistance. So that is 1 upon Yt. The answer you will get is R square plus XL square upon R. So the dynamic resistance or impedance is R square plus XL square by R. Let's check what exactly happening at resonance, especially a parallel circuit is concerned. So once again I will go to Yt expression. So what is happening over here? Yt is given by this expression, and at resonance this term is vanishing. So what is happening? Yt is decreasing. Yt is decreasing. What does that mean? That means impedance is increasing at parallel resonance. This is a very important conclusion we get. So I will write over here, at parallel resonance, admittance decreasing, that is impedance increases. If impedance increases, obviously current drops. So if I draw the nature of current and impedance against the frequency, it will be like this. Impedance increases. So at resonance, you will have a maximum value of Z. So this is a graph of Z, and this Z max is R square plus XL square upon R. And current decreases, so the nature of current will be like this. And the minimum value of I is nothing but V divided by Z max. What about the power factor? Power factor will have the value 1, and that is a maximum at resonance. So if I draw the characteristic of power factor also, it will be like this. So maximum value of power factor is unity. So these are the things happening during parallel resonance. Since current decreases in parallel resonance, that means it is rejecting the current. So I can say this circuit as rejector circuit. So these are the characteristic and expression of a resonant frequency that we have learned, which is appearing during resonance for AC parallel circuit. Thank you.